morning. Welcome to worship. We are so glad that you are here. If you're worshiping with us in person today, we invite you to fill out the tear and share on the back of your bulletin to let us know that you were here and anything else you want us to know, and drop that in one of the offering plates on your way out. If you're worshiping with us online, you don't have a tear and share, but you could comment that you're here. We'd love to know about it. All right. Let us begin worship. I invite you to stand as you are able for the order of confession and forgiveness. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Almighty God, to whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hid, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name, through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
If we say we have no sin, we deceive ourselves, and the truth is not in us. But if we confess our sins, God, who is faithful and just, will forgive our sins and cleanse us from all unrighteousness. Most merciful God, we confess that we are captive to sin and cannot free ourselves. We have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us. Forgive us, renew us, and lead us, so that we may delight in your will and walk in your ways, the glory of your holy name. Amen. In the mercy of Almighty God, Jesus Christ was given to die for us, and for his sake, God forgives us all our sins. As a called and ordained minister of the Church of Christ, and by his authority, I therefore declare to you the entire forgiveness of all your sins. In the name of the Father,
Spirit, open my
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. In peace, let us pray to the Lord. Lord be with you. Let us pray together. Lord Jesus, make us instruments of your peace, that where there is hatred, we may sow love, where there is injury, pardon, where there is despair, hope. Grant, O divine Master, that we may seek to console, to understand, and to love in your name. For you live and reign with the Father and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen.
Joseph said to his brothers, I am Joseph. Is my father still alive? But his brothers could not answer him, so dismayed were they at his presence. Then Joseph said to his brothers, come closer to me. And they came closer. He said, I am your brother Joseph, whom you sold into Egypt. And now do not be distressed or angry with yourselves, because you sold me here. For God sent me before you to preserve life. For the famine has been in the land these 2 years, and there are 5 more years in which there will be neither plowing nor harvest. God sent me before you to preserve for you a remnant on earth, and to keep alive for you many survivors. So it was not you who sent me here, but God. He has made me a father to Pharaoh, and lord of all his house, and ruler over all the land of Egypt. Hurry and go up to my father and say to him, thus says your son Joseph, God has made me lord of all Egypt. Come down to me, do not delay. You shall settle in the land of Goshen, and you shall be near me. You and your children's children, as well as your flocks, your herds, and all that you have. I will provide for you there, since there are 5 more years of famine to come, so that you and your household and all that you have will not come to poverty. And he kissed all his brothers and wept upon them, and after that his brothers talked with him. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. We will read the passage together. Please join me on the bold verses. Do not be provoked by evildoers. Do not be jealous of those who do wrong. For they shall soon wither like the grass, like the green grass fade away. Put your trust in the Lord and do good. Dwell in the land and find safe pasture. Delight in the Lord, who shall give you your heart's desire. Commit your way to the Lord, put your trust in the Lord, and see what God will do. The Lord will make your vindication as clear as the light, and the justice of your case like the noonday sun. Be still before the Lord and wait patiently. Do not be provoked by the one who prospers, the one who succeeds in evil schemes. Refrain from anger, leave rage alone. Do not be provoked. It leads only to evil. For evil doers shall be cut off, but those who hope in the Lord shall possess the land. In a little while, the wicked shall be no more. Even if you search out their place, they will not be there. But the lowly shall possess the land. They will delight in abundance of peace. But the deliverance of the righteous comes from you, O Lord. You are their stronghold in time of trouble. You, O Lord, will help them and rescue them. You will rescue them from the wicked and deliver them, because in you they seek refuge. A reading from Paul's first letter to the Corinthians. But someone will ask, how are the dead raised? With what kind of body do they come? Fool, what you sow does not come to life unless it dies. And as for what you sow, you do not sow the body that is to be, but a bare seed, perhaps a wheat or some other grain. But God gives it a body as he has chosen, and to each kind of seed its own body. So it is with the resurrection of the dead. What is sown is perishable, what is raised is imperishable. It is sown in dishonor, it is raised in glory. It is sown in weakness, it is raised in power. It is sown a physical body, it is raised a spiritual body. If there is a physical body, there is also a spiritual body. Thus is it is written, the first man Adam became a living being, the last Adam became a life-giving spirit. But it is not the spiritual that is first, but the physical and then the spiritual. The first man was from the earth, a man of dust, the second man is from heaven. As was a man of dust, so are those who are of the dust. And as a man of heaven, so are those who are of heaven. Just as we have borne the image of the man of dust, we will also bear the image of the man of heaven. What I am saying, brothers and sisters, is this. Flesh and blood cannot inherit the kingdom of God, nor does the perishable inherit the imperishable. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
The Holy Gospel according to Luke, the 6th chapter.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said, but I say to you that listen, love your enemies, do good to those who hate you, bless those who curse you, pray for those who abuse you. If anyone strikes you on the cheek, offer the other also. and from anyone who takes away your coat, do not withhold even your shirt. Give to everyone who begs from you, and if anyone takes away your goods, do not ask for them again. Do to others as you would have them do to you. If you love those who love you, what credit is that to you? For even sinners love those who love them. If you do good to those who do good to you, what credit is that to you? For even sinners do the same. If you lend to those from whom you hope to receive, what credit is that to you? Even sinners lend to sinners to receive as much again. But love your enemies, do good and lend, expecting nothing in return. Your reward will be great, and you will be children of the Most High, for he is kind to the ungrateful and the wicked. Be merciful, just as your Father is merciful. Do not judge, and you will not be judged. Do not condemn, and you will not be condemned. Forgive, and you will be forgiven. Give, and it will be given to you. A good measure, pressed down, shaken together, running over, will be put into your lap. For the measure you give will be the measure you get back. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
As we consider today's gospel lesson, I think it's going to be most helpful if we start with what this passage is not. This passage is not an endorsement for abuse, violence, or oppression. Some of these verses here about interacting with those who abuse you, those who strike you, those who take from you, have been used to keep people, especially women, in abusive situations. These verses have been used to enable abusers, to prop up domestic violence, and to silence those who would challenge oppression. It is important that we say up front, this is not godly, and this is not what we believe. If we are living according to what Jesus is telling us here, to love, to show mercy, and to be kind, in the ways that God loves, shows mercy, and is kind, it is simply impossible to enable abuse, allow oppression, or endorse violence. Those two ways of being are incompatible. And since we know that love, mercy, and kindness are where Jesus calls us, we have to assume that there's another, better way to understand these verses and the teaching Jesus offers. Jesus is teaching those who have come to him to be healed and have stayed to listen. The crowd just heard the blessings and the woes proclaimed to them, a gospel we heard last week. They have already heard some challenging truths, and this is no different. But it is gospel, good news, because Jesus is teaching them and us how to be healed in spirit and in life. He's teaching how to live fully, holy, in accordance with God's will. Jesus is inviting his followers to live as changed people, empowered by what God has done in their lives. He's proposing living in extravagant generosity with one another. Now, the society surrounding Jesus was based on reciprocal relationships. When people were generous, they expected generosity in return. Even what seemed like charity was often a trade. Patrons would give to those who could not repay them, but loyalty was expected in return. This continues today. Maybe it's a little less formal, but it remains. This is the basic system of self-preservation. If you give things away with no expectation of return, soon you will have nothing, or so logic says. As Jesus says, this is the way of sinners. Just loving those who love you, just doing good to those who do good to you, just lending to those from whom you receive. It's the way of those who center themselves. But Jesus calls his followers to live beyond a reasonable, logical system of relationship, to live beyond self-interest. He calls us to live larger than reciprocity, to live instead of ways of love, mercy, and kindness. even if that's not what we receive in return. It's a big ask when we think about what love and mercy and kindness require. Jesus calls us to love, not friendly love, but agape love, the love that reaches beyond logic or reason to lift up the other into their fullest self. He calls us to be kind, not nice, but kind, which means seeking the best interest of the other person. And he calls us to be merciful, as God is merciful, meaning releasing people from the punishment they deserve. Instead of punishment, it's the possibility of repentance, to turn back to God's will. This love, kindness, and mercy are extravagant. They're even more generous than the golden rule. Do to others as you would have them do to you, Jesus says first. But then Jesus reminds us that a like-for-like relationship is how sinners live. And really, we often discount the way God wants us to be treated. We're willing to set the bar low on how we would have others do to us. Jesus calls us to more. Calling us to more generous living, to more loving relationships, and to more kindness in our interactions, that sounds great. Right until we start to think about our enemies and the hate we experience and the curses we've heard and the abuse we've encountered and the violence we've suffered and the things that have been taken from us. And suddenly, this calling seems outrageous. What Jesus is asking for seems entirely unfair. But as Dr. Brian Peterson says, what we need isn't fairness. What we need is mercy. Mercy is what we need. And it's what we receive first. We are all beggars, to quote Martin Luther. We are all sinners. We have all fallen short. We do not love others as we should. We have been someone's enemy. We have hated. We have taken what is not ours. We have caused harm to others. We do not live up to God's plan for us in our relationships with one another. And we have turned our back on God's will for us at some point along the way. But God loves us beyond what is reasonable, beyond what we can give back. God blesses us, prays for us, gives us chance after chance to repent. We see all of this lived out in Jesus. He welcomed sinners to his table, eating alongside people even as they questioned him. He loved those who chased him out of town. He invited God's people to be transformed then and there, to live into the fullness of their salvation. He gave and gave and gave to the point of giving his life, and he did not ask for it back. Instead, he prayed for those who were killing him as he died. And his love, kindness, and mercy find us here and now. In the waters of baptism, we are blessed. Mercy pours down on us as we receive forgiveness, new life, and the Holy Spirit. God's word leads us and calls us in so that we might repent when we lose our way and follow God's will once more. Jesus welcomes us to his table, giving us his own body and blood of salvation. He welcomes us, knowing full well that we are sinners. That's why we need this meal, after all. We are released from the condemnation we deserve, and we are given the compassion we need. We receive grace upon grace, an overflowing measure of mercy, pressed down, shaken together, running over. This mercy is not scant. It's not a half-hearted scoop. It's a cup full of brown sugar, packed all the way down, with a rounded top spilling over. This mercy is more than enough. It is outrageously generous, and it is what equips us to answer the invitation Jesus gives. Because we have received God's mercy, because we are loved, Because God seeks the best for us, we can live in this way too. We are empowered to break the cycle of brokenness, responding to enemies, abusers, and those who harm with another option. Just as we are called back when we fall short, we call others back in. As we seek the best for one another, we name the places where harm is happening. We hold one another accountable. We offer one another opportunities to turn back, to repent and seek reconciliation with God and one another. This is not enabling sin. It is refusing to let sin continue. This is what it looks like to love one another. When we love, we do not leave one another in sin. We, like Jesus, offer another way, the way of mercy. We do this loving work as a community. At every baptism, we promise, as the church, to pray for each other and to help each other live as God's people. This means we lift each other up, care for each other, and name when we have lost our way. Our community responsibility also means that we do not leave a harmed sibling to do the correcting work. We step forward with them or on their behalf, lifting them back up as we name harm and call our fallen sibling back in. Now, this might seem at odds with what Jesus says about judgment and condemnation, but it's not. When Jesus says, do not judge and do not condemn, he doesn't mean don't name sin. He means don't assume you know how things will end. We are not God, and we don't decide the status of anyone's salvation. We are to hold hope that God can work even in the most unexpected places, the most broken situations, and we are to pray that God's grace would change those who have caused harm. Importantly, offering mercy and withholding judgment does not mean there are never consequences. It means we don't get eternal recompense and the punishment we deserve. There are still consequences here on earth for harm that is done. Restitution is part of repentance and reconciliation. And if we have truly repented, we face our consequences as opportunities to grow in our understanding of love and mercy, and as chances to seek the best for others. Today, Jesus calls us to live in a better way. This way is generous. It is outrageous. It is unfair. It is the way that Jesus lived, and it is the way that God empowers us to go, the way of love, kindness, and mercy. These things Jesus asks are not easy. They require hard work. They require deep trust in God and in one another. And in fact, we might not be able to do all of these things on this side of the resurrection. And that's okay, because God's mercy for us does not depend on our ability to show mercy to others. God's mercy does change us, though. Mercy transforms us, and God's mercy invites us to join in transforming the world. Thanks be to God. Amen.
Thank you. we now profess the faith we share using the words of the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day, he rose again. He ascended into heaven, and he is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. The Spirit of the Lord is poured out upon us in abundance, so we are bold to pray for the church, the world, and all that God has made. You teach us to love our neighbors and enemies alike. Encourage your church to follow the leading of your love, especially when it is risky or difficult. Help us to show mercy just as we have first received mercy. God of grace, nurture fields that lie dormant, resting until it is time to bloom again. Bless farmers and all who cultivate fields and urban gardens. Give favorable weather for planting. Bring forth from buried seed an abundant harvest, and guard against famine and disease. God of grace, look upon our world with mercy, that we delight in an abundance of peace. Protect all whose lives are marred by war and civil unrest. Release political prisoners and amplify the voices that challenge us to seek forgiveness and pursue nonviolence. God of grace, your people cry out for mercy. Console hearts that long for forgiveness. Mend broken relationships. Heal bodies that suffer chronic pain or illness, especially Mary, John, Bob, Michelle, Austin, Bert, Joyce, Sarah, Nancy, Robin, Jim, Pat, Emily, Sylvia, Bill, Steve, Kay, Yvonne, Eric, Mary, Bill, Earl, Barbara, Kathy, and Ted. God of grace, you bind us together into one family. Teach us to forgive one another and to resolve conflicts with humility and patience. Bless families of all shapes and sizes, and show love to those who are lonely or grieving. God of grace, we praise you for the saints who have inherited the fullness of your kingdom. As you have raised them to imperishable and eternal life, sustain us in faith by the promise of resurrection. God of grace, since we have such great hope in your promises, O God, we lift these and all our prayers to you in confidence and faith through Jesus Christ our Savior. Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always. We invite you to share a sign of that peace with those around you. If you're worshiping with us from home, we invite you to share the peace with those you are with, or to give someone a call. That's peace with them. You may be seated. At this time, we give thanks for the many ways that you continue to sustain God's ministry here at Grace. Your time and your effort and your financial gifts, we thank you so much for being partners in ministry. We continue now with the anthem.
Thank you.
At the table, revising the rules, deciding the share, with wisdom and grace, dividing the power, for woman and man, a system that's fair. For young and for old, at the table, a voice to be heard, a part in the song. The hands of a child in hands that are wrinkled, for young and for old, the right to belong. And God will delight when we are created. Just and unjust, a place at the table, abuser abused with need to forgive, in anger in hurt, a mindset of mercy, for just and unjust, a new at the table, a covenant shared, a welcoming space, a rainbow of grace, and gender and color, for gay and for straight, a chalice of grace, for everyone born, at the table, to live without fear, and simply to be, to work to speak of, to witness and worship, for everyone born. Justice and joy,
Let us pray together. Blessed are you, O God, sovereign of the universe. You offer us new beginnings and guide us on our journey. Lead us to your table, nourish us with this heavenly food, and prepare us to carry your love to a hungry world. In the name of Christ, our light. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is our duty and delight that we should everywhere and always offer thanks and praise to you, O God, through Jesus Christ, who is your promised light, which no night can overcome. And so with the church on earth, all creation and the host of heaven, we praise your name and join their unending hymn. Holy One, the beginning and the end, the giver of life, blessed are you for the birth of creation. Blessed are you in the darkness and in the light. Blessed are you for your promise to your people. Blessed are you in the prophet's hopes and dreams. Blessed are you for Mary's openness to your will. Blessed are you for your Son Jesus, the Word made flesh. In the night in which he was handed over, our Lord Jesus took bread. He gave thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." Again, after supper, he took the cup. He gave thanks and gave it for all to drink, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood. It is shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this for the remembrance of me." Let us proclaim the mystery of faith. Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again. With this bread and cup, we remember your word dwelling among us, full of grace and truth. We remember our new birth in his death and resurrection. We look with hope for his coming. Come, Lord Jesus. Holy God, we long for your spirit. Come among us and bless this meal. May your word take flesh in us. Awaken your people. Fill us with your light. Bring the gift of peace on earth. Come, Holy Spirit. All praise and glory are yours, Holy One of Israel, Word of God incarnate, power of the Most High, one God, now and forever. Amen. Gathered into one by the Holy Spirit, let us pray as Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Come now to God's table. There is a place for you, and there is enough for all. Thanks be to God. You may be seated. Today we will be communing around the altar rail. We invite you to come forward, coming down the center aisle, kneeling or standing around the rail. Let us know if you need gluten-free. We do offer that. Let us know if you prefer a blessing and return on the side aisles. If you wish for us to come to you at the end, I will be looking, so just give me a wave. Let us begin our celebration of Holy Communion. Thank you. the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, strengthen you and keep you in his grace. Amen. Let us pray together. We give you thanks, gracious God, for we have feasted on the abundance of your house. Send us to bring good news and to proclaim your favor to all, strengthened with the richness of your grace in your Son, Jesus Christ. Amen. So for this week, Pastor Rachel and I will be out of the office the first couple days. We're part of a pilot program that the Synod is trying out with some rostered leaders, so we're a couple of guinea pigs for the next couple days, but Michelle can still get a hold of us at the church office if you need something. Seniors at Grace this week makes its triumphant return to the Fellowship Hall. Let us know if you want to be a part of that. And we have a pancake supper on Shrove Tuesday coming up, along with burning of the palms. Not the pancakes, just the palms. And that's a couple Tuesdays from now, so keep an eye out for that and let us know in the Terran Share if you will be attending. Now receive God's blessing. Almighty God, who leads you in pathways of righteousness, who rejoices over you, and who calls you by name, bless your going out and your coming in, today and forevermore. Amen.